Hello traders, again welcome back to another video. So before starting the video, I have to disclose something. So now the course registration, I mean the Binary Sun 7 trading program registration is started. So if you are interested, you can contact me, and here we can see the market is going upside now, but now it start to come down. The market want to reverse, and here almost to this area there are some levels, and now it's rejecting, but here we can go to sellers. I placed here put option because we can see two very weak bullish candles, okay, and also we are seeing a sellers entry at that level. That's why I placed here put option. And just wait, I will show something also here. If we draw a line here, okay, everyone will think, oh, that candle closed at the level and it's a rejection, so everyone will place call option. Actually, don't do like that, because here it's indicate the seller's interest, okay, not the rejection. The sellers want to go more down because a strong bearish candle here when compared to that two bullish candles. Now the red candle is strong and there is a resistance also. It was a winning trade, okay, you can see it was also sellers. So here Nexon also should be bearish, but I need a good entry, then we can go with sellers again. Okay, here we can go with sellers. I placed here put option because it also a confirmation candle, that's the sellers want to again go more down, that's why I placed here put option. Okay, you can see sellers entry from that level, it should be definitely bearish. Okay, it's very accurate trade, that's why I go with sellers here. Now we can see some levels almost to this area. It is the next possible reversal. Okay, it is the next possible reversal area almost to that level. Here also between this area the buyers may enter at any time. After hitting that level also the buyers may enter. This whole area that we can consider as a support area, but here I am going to place put option again because now that candle crossed that level, so now that support is going to act as a resistance, so it should be definitely bearish. Most of the time it should be, I don't know why, it's bullish entry, maybe it may make retracement, but now I am seeing a momentum, and that candle was strong candle, that's why I placed here put option. I don't know, I think there is no rejection, no problem, it's a okay fine. It was in the last second it was bearish, that's the power of the candlestick analyze. Okay, if we have the proper knowledge, we can easily make good profit from the binary option, but we must have the proper knowledge about the candlestick analyze. And also today it's OTC market, so there are lot of manipulations in the OTC. Mostly they are doing the fast momentum and also the gap up and gap down opening. Okay, that also it's very very important. Okay, we need to give importance for gap up and gap down when we are trading in the OTC market, and also in the real market. Also in the 1 minute chart we can see so many gap. Okay, so we can trade after the closing of this present candle. Here okay, you can see there is a gap up open now. Okay, there is a gap up open, it is the opening point. Okay, actually you can see the, it's not open exactly at the closing point of the previous candle, it was the closing point of previous candle, but now that bullish candle open above that level. Okay, I expect it also should be bearish because it's made a gap up open. In the OTC market, there is another one thing, that's the OTC will give you fake movements, but the market will continue its trend or its direction. Okay, so when you are trading in the OTC market, must give priority for the trend or direction of the market. It's very, very important. Okay, just give important for the trend and momentum, etc. Okay, it will give you fake movements, but the market is not going to reverse. That is the psychology of the OTC market. Okay, so just follow the momentum. That's the only solution to get success in the OTC market. Then we can easily make money without proper knowledge. Again, I am telling, for trading in the OTC market, there are a lot of manipulation and lot of issues. I agree that, but if you follow the momentum or trend, you can easily make money from the OTC market. Here we can see a support area, and it is the possible reversal. You can see bullish entry from that level. After hitting that level, you can see buyers entry, strong buyers, very strong buyers are entering now from that exact level. Here also we can see a gap down open. Now still there is a gap to the resistance, so I expect next one here should be bullish because it is the, okay, almost this level is the resistance, so still it made a gap. Okay, now it opened here, means at least for 1 minute again we can expect a bullish entry, but I don't trade here because sometimes it will go up and reject from that resistance and finally made like this. Okay, here also so many sellers entry, so I expect it also should be bullish because of that gap down, but there is a level, so it will be risky. Okay, you can see finally again bullish candle, but it's very strong and it's crossed that level also, so next one also should be bullish here. That's the most probability because I expect a weak candle, but that candle is continuation candle. Okay, but I need a good entry. If I get a good entry, then I will definitely go with buyers because here the next candle should be bullish. Okay, it's coming down, so we can go with buyers. I placed here call option, but my entry is little bit late, I think. No problem, I expect it should close above my entry because now that previous candle is a confirmation candle to go with buyers. But I think seller's entry, I don't know why. I placed my trade with confirmation candle. Okay, buyers are also trying. Okay, it was also winning trade. Today I took only confirmed trades. Here the probability of the next candle also should be bullish because of that new high, but I need a rejection. Here we can go with buyers. Oh, it's little bit late entry because of fast momentum. I got a strong rejection. Okay, that's why I placed here call option, because that strong rejection is the confirmation to go with buyers. Okay, that rejection indicate the buyers want to enter. The buyers are active at that area. That's why now I saw a strong rejection. Okay, and if we go and check the 5-second chart, then we can see some strong bullish entry. Okay, that's called the 5-second confirmation. Okay, it was also winning trade, but now we can see it's made a gap up open. Look at the left side. Here it was the closing point, but it's open above. Okay, it's open at the seller's area now. You can see the It's open near to the cellars area. We can see some strong cellars entry from that level. I expect the candle may reject because of that cellars area. Okay, I expect it should be bearish, but the time is over because I expect it to reject because now it's made a gap up open here. It's open at the sellers area and also there is a raw number. In the OTC market, the raw number is very, very important. So we can see, I expect it should be bearish. Okay, I think, okay, you can see it's finally at the last second it made a bearish candle. Okay, after hitting almost to this area, that's the power of the candlestick analyze. Because in the OTC market, if we want to trade, we need to give importance for some logic than the rules. Okay, OTC is it's entirely different from the real market. Okay, so when you are trading the OTC market, we need to add something, okay, some additional tricks to get success. And here again we can see sellers entry. Now we are seeing some strong sellers entry, so we can wait here. But now we are seeing rejection, the buyers rejecting from the bottom. But in this kind of area, both the buyers and sellers are fighting. Okay. Anyway, we can wait for this candle to close. Then after we can trade. That should be good. Because there is a raw number above. Maybe at the last second it may hit that raw number and go down also. But in the bottom we can see the buyers are strongly rejecting from the bottom. So in this kind of area, if you are trading, must keep a margin of safety. If you go to the buyers or if you go to the sellers, must keep a margin of safety. Okay, it was bullish. Again, we can see bullish entry. Okay, now we are seeing strong bullish entry. No problem. There are a lot of opportunities in the market. So just wait for the right opportunity and place your trade. Okay. That's a part of emotion. Okay, it's very, very important. There are a lot of opportunities. If you lose a chance, then just wait for another chance. Okay, in 1 minute and 5 minutes and in 8 minutes, you will get a lot of opportunities. Okay, so there is no need for greedy, something like that. Okay, we can change the pair. And here the market is going down and now it's consolidating and also following the green red pattern. So here we can go with sellers, but I need a good entry. Okay, here I'm going to place put option. Okay, very good entry. Here also we can go with sellers. Here also need a good entry. Here there is a gap up, so I'm going to place put option because of that gap up open. Here also I'm going to place put option with some margin up. Oh bullshit, I think the time is over now. It's my mistake, but the present candle should definitely close below my entry because there is a resistance there, so it should definitely reject after hitting that level. Okay, it was winning trade, but here there is no sign of sellers. That's why I am seeing a doji here. So the next candle should be bullish. That's the most probability here. It was also, I placed here put option because of that gap up open. You can see there is a gap up open. Now the market opened at the seller's area. That's why I placed here put option, because of that gap up. Otherwise, I place call option only. But here, I don't get my entry in this time frame. That's why you can see it closed below my entry. I told you there is a resistance and it should definitely close below my entry. But because of time issues, maybe losing trade. You can see now stones entering now. So, no problem. The losses are common. There is okay, it was close. But if you are seeing this kind of market, don't take trade in this kind of market. It's very bad market. It's looking, you can see so many wicks, so many weak candles, and you will definitely face a lot of fast momentum if you are trading in this kind of bad market. Okay, must keep, I mean, if you want to trade in this kind of market, you must keep a margin of safety also. But I don't suggest anyone to trade in this kind of market. Always find a healthy market, and it's the result. I think I got two losses and others are winning trade. Anyway, that's enough, because I'm going to stop this video. So if anyone want to participate in our binary sunstone trading program, they can contact me. My contact details on the description. Now from now, the course registration is going to start. In the last week I was unable to make that, so from now the course registration is started. So many people made inquiry for that, and such people can contact me from now. So I am going to stop this video. All of you, wish you good profit.